Siddhartha, an Indian tale, is a novel by the German author Hermann Hesse, published in 1922. It's about a man who spends his life trying to attain enlightenment. I like this story. In this analysis, I focus on the story, not the work as a whole, nor its themes. I've broken down the story into sequences with key influences, key story arc pieces, and major plot points. Siddhartha, the protagonist of the story, grows up in an idyllic setting. His daily life consists of performing ablutions, making sacred offerings to the gods, and meditation. He shows the capacity for acquiring knowledge and skills. He already knows much, at least according to his father and the local wise men. The knowledge acquired at a young age is what drives Siddhartha to search for more. Most parents think their children are smart and beautiful. In Siddhartha's case, others see these qualities in him as well. The local wise men see potential in him. The local girls find him attractive. Siddhartha's best friend, Govinda, places him even higher than the others, wants to follow him, wants to be his companion and servant in the days to come when Siddhartha will ascend to godhood. This childish adoration Govinda shows to his friend explains why he chooses to follow him into the unknown. Restless thoughts butter Siddhartha. He seeks to find his inner self, but doubts that the knowledge he can receive from his father and the local wise men is not enough. Seeing a group of samanas, ascetics, sparks the idea to leave his father's house. Finding the pristine source, attaining enlightenment, is Siddhartha's story goal. At a young age, he has already learned much and understands that the world is vast. And there are more teachers, more sources of knowledge. He does not shun the idea of having a lowly ascetic as a teacher. With his father as the first obstacle on his journey to enlightenment, Siddhartha must break the parental bond, take a step towards independence. This is his first test. Should he be unable to stand up to his father, the gatekeeper, he would never leave home, never see the world, never find new teachers, and thus never reach his goal. He is restless and unhappy. He must leave home. Still, he does not escape in the night, which would be the easy way to avoid confrontation, but faces his father with pride. Siddhartha demonstrates patience and intelligence in the way he confronts his father regarding him joining the samanas, the ascetics. His father, who loves his son, does not want to even discuss the matter. He has been looking forward to his son growing up to be a cleric. Siddhartha stands still in a room through the night, resolved not to move a muscle until he gets his father's permission to join the ascetics. In the morning, the father yields, and make sure to promise his son is always welcome back home, should Siddhartha choose to leave the ascetic life behind, so they can get back to their daily routines. This means Siddhartha can retreat back to the status quo, should he give up his quest. Govinda, who adores Siddhartha, does not shun the idea of leaving the good life behind and join the ascetics, as long as he can follow his friend. With the samanas, Siddhartha commits himself to a single goal. He practices self-denial. He fasts, meditates, and exposes himself to the elements, with the goal of becoming empty, so that he can find enlightenment in the emptiness that the practice creates in him. Govinda takes notice of his friend's progress, commenting on how the old samanas admire him. One day you'll be a holy man, Govinda says to Siddhartha. Siddhartha is not content with reaching for emptiness. Fasting and meditating offer only a momentary escape from life. he recognizes that he has a thirst for knowledge, but he is starting to suspect that attaining enlightenment is something that does not come through teachings. Being smart, he does not completely renounce all teachings yet, merely because of the emerging doubts. This starts the debate, leaving him with two choices: remain a student or leave all teachings behind. He is at home with teachers and practice, but he doubts reaching his goal is possible by following a teaching. Renouncing all teachings would mean casting himself into the unknown, where he would have to fumble for his goal alone. The debate still continues after he leaves the ascetics and meets the Buddha Gautama. When they decide to leave the samanas, Govinda wants to go listen to the teachings of the Buddha, the perfected man. Siddhartha agrees but notes that he does not think hearing the Buddha will be any good, saying, "In my heart I believe that we've already tasted the best fruit of these teachings." Voicing their desire to leave the ascetics group, they are met with resistance from the eldest of the samanas. Siddhartha demonstrates the abilities he has learned from the samanas by subduing the elder with nothing but his gaze. In doing this, Siddhartha proves that he has not spent his years with the ascetics without learning anything, and he still desires to leave. This shows how much he has come to doubt teachings. Govinda remarks how Siddhartha learned more from the samanas than he knew. "You would soon have learned to walk on water," he says. "I do not seek to walk on water," Siddhartha answers. After spending all that time with the ascetics, he still has his original goal in mind. The protagonist Siddhartha is the namesake of the founder of Buddhism, Siddhartha Gautama. The meeting of Siddhartha and Gautama takes place in Savatthi, a historical town where Siddhartha Gautama is said to have lived. The Buddha Gautama is someone who has achieved what Siddhartha is trying to achieve. He is the teacher with the most potential, whom Siddhartha has to face before he can turn his back to all teachers. When he sees a man in yellow robe collecting alms, Siddhartha recognizes him to be the Buddha from the way he carries himself. Instantly, Siddhartha venerates and loves the man who is truthful down to the gesture of his last finger, and he acknowledges that the Buddha is holy. Even then, Siddhartha does not believe the holy man's teachings can offer him anything. The Buddha Gautama speaks of life as the origin of suffering. The salvation from suffering is the way of the Buddha, following his teachings. Govinda wishes to become a follower of the Buddha and urges Siddhartha to join him. Siddhartha refuses, commending his friend for making his own decision. His resolution holds even if it means parting with his childhood friend. Siddhartha has a chance to converse with the Buddha Gautama alone. Listening to the Buddha's teachings is not enough. Siddhartha has to talk to him about the error he has found in the teachings. Without confronting the teacher with the most potential, one who has achieved that which he is striving to achieve, he would be unable to leave all teachings and teachers behind with full confidence in his quest for enlightenment. With all the proper respect, Siddhartha points out to the Buddha that Gautama himself did not follow teachings to attain Buddhahood. "You have found salvation in death," Siddhartha says. "It has come to you in the course of your own search, your own path, through thoughts, through meditation, through enlightenment. It has not come to you by means of teachings. Thus is my thought. Nobody will obtain salvation by means of teachings." Gautama does not start arguing with the young man who seeks to point an error in his teachings, saying only that his teachings are no opinion. Their goal is not to explain the world to those who seek knowledge. Siddhartha notes to himself that since Gautama was able to reach the innermost part of self, he also will seek to reach the innermost part of himself. Siddhartha leaves the Buddha Gautama and his friend Govinda behind. He feels that he is leaving his old life behind. He understands that he is a changed man. He cannot return to his father's house. With the realization that he does not know anything of himself, he decides that he wants to learn from himself, be his own student. This short sequence makes the already formed story goal more concrete. Siddhartha wants to achieve enlightenment without teachers or teachings. It also ends the debate phase and pushes the protagonist into the unknown world, barring the return to status quo. The courtesan Kamala is Siddhartha's mentor in learning to know himself. She teaches the unexperienced man in the art of love. In one way, she fills the role for the love interest, but Siddhartha seeks an intimate relationship with her only on a physical level. As she learns to understand Siddhartha better, she realizes he is unable to love. When Siddhartha sees the beautiful Kamala being carried by servants in a chair, he enters the city with the goal of meeting her. Handsome Siddhartha sparks Kamala's interest, but she only wishes to meet with men who dress nicely and bring her gifts and money. When asked what he is able to do, Siddhartha answers, "I can think, I can wait, I can fast." Learning that Siddhartha is literate, Kamala arranges for him a meeting with a merchant for whom he can offer his service. Siddhartha's decisions to leave home and become an ascetic and then detach himself from teachings are reactive, driven by instinct, not by a concrete goal. As he steps into the unknown world where no one is telling him what to do and starts pursuing the goal of being in Kamala's favor, he transitions to proactive. The merchant Kamaswami is Siddhartha's gateway into the childlike games, which Siddhartha needs to enter to be able to obtain the money that the courtesan Kamala's favor requires of him. The merchant Kamaswami receives Siddhartha with the impression that the young man is a destitute Brahman. Siddhartha, thinking he is somehow better than the old, childlike merchant, proves his literacy by highlighting the virtue of patience. Kamaswami sees potential in the young man and takes him under his wing. Under the employment of the merchant, Siddhartha will have to deal with worldly things like money and business and will have to get involved in what he sees as childlike games. Siddhartha takes part in the business of the merchant Kamaswami. He visits the courtesan Kamala daily, wearing fine clothes and bringing her gifts. The purpose of his life is with Kamala, not with the business. He sees himself above other people and does not care to invest himself in his work. Kamaswami notes that Siddhartha is not a proper businessman, nor will he ever be, but possesses a mysterious quality which brings him success. As the source of his being, which originally sent him on his quest to attain enlightenment, runs from him, Siddhartha becomes scared, wishing he could truly participate in the naive occupations of the childlike people with his heart, but feels like only a spectator to their games. Kamala tells Siddhartha that he is the best lover she has had, and that she would someday want to bear his child. She also sees that Siddhartha is unable to love anybody. As years pass by, Siddhartha becomes tired and lost in his new life. Finding himself in the activities of the childlike people proves impossible, but the guiding voice inside of him, which he listened to in his youth, becomes silent. Siddhartha takes part in the childlike people's activities with more passion before waking up to his situation. The way he has been going through life seems worthless and pointless. He decides to leave the current life, leave Kamaswami, leave Kamala, and leave his possessions. Kamala is not surprised Siddhartha left. Later, she finds out that she is carrying his child. Siddhartha arrives at a river. Feeling that he's reached the end, failed in his goal to attain enlightenment, there is nothing left to do than annihilate himself. He prepares to fall into the river and drown himself. This is the midpoint reversal of the story. Years spent among the childlike people have left Siddhartha not finding what he was looking for and further away from his goal than ever before. Siddhartha wanted to attain enlightenment without teachers and he failed to do so. The holy word Om, which he has known since childhood, wakes his dormant spirit and makes him realize the foolishness of his action. After sleeping under a tree, Siddhartha wakes up to find his old friend, Govinda, sitting nearby. Having not recognized his friend, Govinda, follower of the Buddha, sat down to guard a man sleeping out in the open. Siddhartha recognizes his friend and confesses to him that he does not know what he is doing, what he's going to be tomorrow. Siddhartha realizes he is not more able to boast with his skills of fasting, waiting, and thinking, like he did in his youth. He has become a childlike person himself. The ferryman Vasudeva is Siddhartha's last mentor and at the same time a friend and a father figure. The simple man has found peace living by the river, taught by the river, and with his guidance, Siddhartha learns to listen to the river as well. Watching the river run, Siddhartha thinks to himself, "Great be he who would grasp this, understand this." Siddhartha tells the ferryman Vasudeva the story of his life, and the old ferryman listens with care. At the end of his tale, Siddhartha speaks of the river and the holy word Om. Vasudeva concludes that the river has spoken to Siddhartha and asks him to stay with him. The river has taught Vasudeva and he believes everything can be learned from it. He will take Siddhartha as his helping hand so that Siddhartha will learn from the river as well. Siddhartha stays with Vasudeva, learns all the skills needed in the trade, and works the fields. His true teacher during this time is the river. He learns to listen with a waiting and open soul, without passion, without opinion. From the river, he learns how there is no time, how his young self and current self are only separated by a shadow, not by something real. Over time, Siddhartha becomes more like Vasudeva, almost as bright, almost as blissful. Travelers passing by think the two are brothers. Siddhartha is on the right path, almost at the goal, close to enlightenment. Even so, he is not ready to reach his goal. A middle-aged man with plenty of life experience, he has yet to experience something important, which keeps him from understanding himself and, thus, from reaching his goal. News of the Buddha Gautama being on his deathbed reached Siddhartha. Thinking of the wise man, Siddhartha thinks there is nothing standing between them anymore, although he still can't accept the Buddha's teachings. Kamala sets on a journey to see the dying Buddha with her son, young Siddhartha, named after his father. On the way, she is bitten by a venomous snake by the river. Vasudeva finds them and carries the injured woman to the hut. Siddhartha finds his ex-lover dying, wanting to help her, but seeing there is nothing to be done. He also sees something familiar in the boy, whom he has never seen before. Kamala tells him that the boy is his son. She wants to know if Siddhartha ever found peace, and looking at him, she says, "I'm seeing it, I too will find peace." She had wanted to see the face of the perfected one, but finding Siddhartha in the Buddha's place is just as good for her. When Kamala dies, Vasudeva remarks how Siddhartha is experiencing suffering, but no sadness seems to have entered his heart. Siddhartha says he cannot be sad because his son has been given to him. Siddhartha's stubborn and disobedient son is the embodiment of his final test, his last lesson, which will cause him grief and seemingly bring him further from his goal, but ultimately lead him to it. Siddhartha calls himself rich and happy now that his son has entered his life, but soon finds out the pampered boy used to rich life is not at home in the simple hut by the river. Siddhartha attempts to win the boy over with love and patience. This causes him only grief. Having never before loved another person, Siddhartha is only now learning what it means, suffering for another person as the childlike people do, which he looked down upon before. Vasudeva advises Siddhartha to let the boy return to the town, back to his old life. Siddhartha is unable to heed the advice of his friend and mentor. He has experienced the outside world. He doesn't want to let the boy get lost in life. After spending months with Siddhartha, the boy still hasn't grown accustomed to his father and new living standards. One night, he steals Vasudeva's money and a boat and makes his escape. Fearing for the boy's safety and unable to let him go due to the attachment he's developed, Siddhartha goes after the boy, again unable to listen to Vasudeva's advice. The boy is doing what Siddhartha could not do himself, but he cannot accept it. At the gates of the town where Siddhartha spent most of his adulthood, he has an epiphany. He realizes his desire to keep the boy with him, hoping he would learn to love him, was foolish and that he should not cling to the boy. Although Siddhartha returns to the river to live with Vasudeva, and seemingly everything returns to normal, a burning wound caused by his love for his son keeps bothering him, causing him to look at the childlike people in a new light and understand them. Before his son was introduced to him, Siddhartha was seemingly close to his goal. Having found someone to suffer for and learn to love, it seems like he was never close to his goal, even though he had left the childlike games behind. Having loved and lost, left with a burning wound and a new understanding for the childlike people, Siddhartha seems to be left on the last threshold, reaching for his goal, never to retrieve it. In the end, it's only due to this last big obstacle on his path that he is able to finally achieve his goal, which would not have been possible before. Suffering from his wound, Siddhartha no longer sees himself better than other people. He has learned to understand their life that is guided by urges and wishes. Seeing his reflection on the river's surface, he recognizes his father's face. He understands how his own father must have felt when he left home to become an ascetic, and sees how he is both like his father and son. Siddhartha stops fighting his fate, stops suffering. Old Vasudeva notes that this is something he has been waiting for a long time, says his farewell, and goes to the forest to die. Having all the life experience, all the needed information in use, and demonstrating growth by understanding both his father and his son, Siddhartha achieves his story goal, retrieves enlightenment, apotheosis of the spiritual nature. Before this, he only believed himself that there was nothing standing between him and the Buddha Gautama, the one who had achieved what he was striving for. While the inner peace he had found by the river was enough to bring Kamala peace on her deathbed, only now the ferryman Vasudeva, another one who had already achieved what Siddhartha was trying to achieve, acknowledged Siddhartha's enlightenment. In his old age, Govinda, Siddhartha's childhood friend, goes to see a wise ferryman. Recognizing Siddhartha, Govinda is happy to see his old friend again, and eager to find out if Siddhartha found what he was looking for. He wants to know if Siddhartha followed a teaching or had teachers. What kind of insights has he found? Siddhartha contradicts the Buddha, the one whose teachings Govinda has followed all his adult life, by telling that wisdom cannot be passed on and that love is the most important thing of all. Govinda thinks his old friend is odd, but identifies in him the same type of holiness that he felt in the Buddha Gautama. As a last request, before they will part for what is probably the last time due to their ages, Govinda asks for one more word, something to ease his path, which is often hard. Siddhartha asks Govinda to bend down and kiss his forehead. Govinda has a similar experience than Siddhartha had with the river. He experiences Siddhartha's enlightened state. Siddhartha's smile reminds Govinda of everything he has ever loved in his life, what had ever been valuable and holy to him in his life. In his youth, Govinda had childish hopes of following Siddhartha when his friend would ascend to godhood. Decades later, those hopes are fulfilled. The ferryman Vasudeva witnesses Siddhartha reach his story goal. Govinda experiences it. After reaching his goal, Siddhartha returns to a new normal, bringing a boon to the one he left behind. That concludes my analysis of Siddhartha, an Indian tale.